Hi, I'm Petri, Product Manager with M-Water, and I'm here with the Ugandan Water Project and The Water Project to talk about an exciting new feature for M-Water and Solstice, which is the ability to embed any of your visualizations and maps directly into your own websites, wherever they are. And we'll cover what the Ugandan Project, Water Project, and the Water Project are all about, and how this new feature works, and what specific use are these organizations getting out of the feature, and to prime you, anybody, to use the same feature and get your visualizations embedded.
Perfect. So my name is Tanner Hoffman. I'm the program director for the Ugandan Water Project. So the Ugandan Water Project is a nonprofit organization that implements WASH solutions in Uganda. We focus a lot on rainwater collection systems, borehole rehabilitations. We do some new borehole drilling, some work with filters, and we're focusing a lot on operation and maintenance of those water sources. We're longtime M-Water users. We love M-Water. We've been using it since 2015. And really, we use M-Water for the entirety of our project cycle. We have a pre-site assessment that we complete, you know, before we even do installation. We use M-Water for that. We have an installation report that we do at installation. Again, M-Water. And then all of our monitoring is using M-Water, and our reporting as well. We try to report back as much of our data as possible to donors and collaborators. And we've found some ways to do that, you know, using M-Water. But I'd say we really value using data to drive our decisions, and we also value the transparency and the data sharing side of it as well. And we really wanted to invest in this feature in particular, being able to embed dashboards and maps into websites to open up the possibility for more collaboration. We wanted to make, you know, transparency more accessible to all M-Water users. And the broader WASH sector. You know, so for a long time, we've wanted to, you know, find a way to, you know, share some of our data from M-Water directly on our website. You know, one way is through a map that shows where all of our projects are installed and the functionality status of those projects. So that's one thing that we've wanted for some time. And this feature really allows us to do that now, and it allows us to do it in a very easy way. So, you know, for quite a while, it's been possible to get your M-Water data on your website using the M-Water API, but it wasn't super easy and streamlined, and it required some level of expertise to get that up there. But this feature really lowers the barriers for that, and it makes being transparent much more accessible to all M-Water users, and that's what we're so excited about. So we're super grateful for this collaboration. You know, big thanks to M-Water, big thanks to the Water Project. And now actually I want to hand over to Spencer from the Water Project to talk a little bit more about, you know, their programs and what they're doing with M-Water.
Thanks, Tanner. Hi, I'm Spencer Bogle, the Director of Program with the Water Project. And the Water Project also is a nonprofit building WASH programs in Kenya, Uganda, and Sierra Leone. We depend on M-Water for our monitoring and evaluation data, as well as our operation and maintenance data, and we are definitely excited about this new feature. One of the central pillars on which the Water Project was built is a commitment to the ongoing reliability of the water points and programs that we develop. We recognize that reliability of projects depends on trust within the relationships that constitute social arrangements around a shared rural water point. And throughout the history of the Water Project, we've worked to share the functionality data that we have when we have it with all stakeholders involved with TWP programs, from the water point users to on the ground teams to local government officials to donors who value verifiable impact. And for years, we've done this through clear, easily discernible visuals on our website in real time, the green, yellow, red visuals. And M-Water helps us to show with every water point, is it working? Is it partially functional but in need of repair? Or is it broken with no water available? And the embeddable dashboards allow us to integrate our data communication and resources and to make our regional data public. It provides a closer look that accentuates the accountability and transparency we believe to be necessary for successful WASH interventions. And the question we are asking, are the people relying on these water points actually accessing water now? And these dashboards with M-Water, they've long helped us to make visual the data that we're looking at as we communicate with our teams working in Kenya, Uganda, Sierra Leone. And the ability to embed the dashboards makes the information available to everyone. And we wanted to be an active part in making this feature available to the sector for anyone working to reduce the gap between the reality on the ground and the impact, the communication of their WASH organization or institutions. So thanks to M-Water, we're really excited to be a part of this feature.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you, Spencer. Thanks, Tanner. So next, let me just demonstrate for everybody how this feature works, because it is indeed available and built in now into the core of M-Water, and M-Water is a free platform for managing WASH data anywhere in the world at any scale. We also have written guidance on this, but really it's just a couple of steps that you need to consider. So I'm now on the M-Water portal at portal.mwater.co, where generally the collection and management and visualization of your WASH data can happen. And here is where I can build maps. Anybody can build maps, dashboards, data tables, and so on. And for each of these, there's the option already to share them. So if I take the example, just an example dashboard, I can go to any of them. And at the top bar, we see the share option. And now, for a new one, all I need to do is create a shareable link, and each of these different shareable links, each of them has this embed link at the bottom right. And this is what generates automatically a piece of HTML code that you or your webmaster can embed straight onto your website. So what's happening is that you're rendering this dashboard, the map you've designed directly in your website, and it's being served from our servers. So you get this code and you can paste it in to the right place on your own website. If you want to try it out, you can take the URL, this embed URL, and test it out to see what that would look like just on its own. So it takes away all of the M-Water top bars, and you get the core of what you're wanting to display. So this, in this case, this interactive dashboard where all the widgets link to each other, where you can have your data tables, your various charts, your interactive maps, as we'll see. And that's indeed available for all maps, all dashboards, or consoles for any user right now. So that's for that. Huge thanks to Ugandan Water Project and the Water Project. And that's the general easy 1, 2, 3 of it. But it'd be great to see how this has already been used by you guys. Tanner, did you have an example for us?
Yeah, I do. So thanks for going through the details there, Petri. I'm going to share my screen now, and it should bring us up to our website. So, you know, right now I'm just on our website. I can scroll to the bottom, and we have a section on our impact page of our website where we have our map embedded. So, you know, like I said before, one of the big priorities for UWP was being able to get a map on our website that, you know, showed all of our water points, and we can share that information with, you know, donors, collaborators, anyone really. So this was a high priority for us. You know, it's a relatively basic application of how to use this feature. You know, we see lots of opportunities in the future for sharing, you know, more data, whether it be, you know, really robust functionality data or water quality data. But for now, we prioritize getting this map up. So what this map is showing for us is all of our major projects ever installed. And it's broken down by project type. So, and that's how it's color coded. So, you know, our wells, our boreholes, they're in red. Our rainwater collection systems are in blue. And then we did a gravity fed pipe scheme, which is shown in green. But, you know, this map and the way it interacts is just the same as using the dashboard in the portal itself. So MWater users should be super familiar with it. And it should be pretty intuitive for anyone that comes on our website. So we have some quick filters at the top here. I can filter it down by project type, for instance. So it's fully interactive. Now it's just showing our rainwater collection systems, which is great. You know, also we have a lot of grassroots donors who fund projects for the Ugandan Water Project. So, you know, those grassroots donors, they're assigned a project number for their water point. And they can actually come in and search the status of their water point and see some images of the water point that they helped to fund using this map now. So, you know, I can click on this and I can type in a project number of interest. So let's say I was the funder for Project 430. I can pull that up. And you can click on these icons to get pop-ups, so custom pop-ups, which show more details. And these are all programs in the dashboard on the back end. So I can open this up, you know, the project number, the name of the facility, some images display right away. And I can also scroll down and see some more information about this project. So it's a rainwater system. It has our installation date, the most recent visit by a Ugandan Water Project staff, which was earlier this month, and then its functionality status as of that last visit. So that's just a quick way to show you some of the capabilities of this feature and how we're currently using it. So, you know, this is really exciting for us to have this up on our website. We see, you know, a lot of opportunities for, you know, our donors and our partners to become more engaged this way. But we also see tremendous opportunity in the future for more collaboration and data sharing between organizations and governments or, you know, other water authorities. And we really see this as a way that, you know, even water authorities could be more transparent with the citizens that, you know, they're representing. And it can be a way that, you know, governments and contractors can share data more easily. So, you know, we're really excited about this. You know, as I mentioned before, it's making being transparent much more accessible to all MWater users. And that's super exciting for us. So yeah, I'm interested to see how the Water Project is using this feature currently. So I think Allison is going to walk us through that right now.
Okay, so this is our website. This is the Water Project website. I'm on our live impact tracking page. And just to start, here is the map that Spencer mentioned previously. So we were able to set this up years ago using a custom setup to make the functionality data that we've been collecting on MWater visible on our website. You can see all of the water points that we've ever installed. Each water droplet represents a project or a group of projects. And I won't do it right now, but if you zoom into this map, you can see more information on specific projects, including the current functional status of each water point, the green, yellow, red that Spencer mentioned. So if you scroll down on this page, you're able to see our new embedded dashboard. The map above that I just showed you is showing all of the projects we've ever done across different countries. But we're using the new MWater embed feature to offer a more in-depth view into each of our current program areas: Western Kenya, Southeastern Kenya, Uganda, and Sierra Leone. So for each program, we have a pie chart that shows the current functionality status of each water point. We have data collectors that are visiting each of these water points 4 times per year and collecting the functionality data using an M-Water survey. Recently, we've actually been replacing a lot of those in-person visits with phone calls due to COVID. So what you're seeing here is functionality data collected but from, you know, either visits or phone calls. We have green for functional water points that are fully functional, no repair needed, yellow for partially functional, indicating that a repair is needed, and red for those water points that are not functional. Above each of the pie charts is a map of the region with each of the water points, also using the green, yellow, red functionality status on the map, which is cool. It matches the pie chart below. And as Petri pointed out, there's the ability to filter within these embedded dashboards, which is really cool. So I just clicked a non-functional, the not functional slice of a pie, and we're able to just filter, you know, specific projects that were marked as not functional during the last monitoring visit. You can also, you know, click on these specific projects. Tanner was showing that, and you can, you know, see the most recent visit, the water point type, the latest functionality status for individual points on the map, which is really great. So I was able to create this dashboard really quickly. I have a lot of experience creating dashboards on M-Water that we've been sharing with internally through the M-Water app. So it was quick for me to create this, and it was also really quick for us to embed it into our website. We were able to do that really easily with this new feature, which is really great. And what we're doing with this particular dashboard here, this allows us to break out the bigger map that I showed you initially, the map that's been on our site for a while, into the specific program areas. And we're also now able to include these pie charts. And breaking the data out in this way is allowing us to create an additional level of accountability and transparency. It's really important to the Water Project that we make this information accessible to everyone involved with us. Donors, partners, water users, anyone who visits our website is able to access this information. So as I said, you know, creating and sharing this particular dashboard was really quick and easy, but we plan to be using this feature to share more of the data that we're collecting in the future, to be creating additional dashboards and embedding more data in our website. We're still thinking through what that will look like and exactly what we're planning to share, but I'm really excited for all the possibilities that this new feature will offer for us to share more of the data that we've been collecting.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you, Allison. Thank you, Tanner, for the really exciting examples already in such short notice and quite versatile examples as well. It's thrilling to see them and thrilling to imagine what other users out of our whole bunch of over 75,000 users of M-Water can make of this feature. I'll make sure to add those websites to the video notes, as well as links to the written guidance on this feature. But I think maybe we can leave it at that and just let people get their hands on this new feature. Yeah, thank you, everybody.
Thank you.